das konnte sehr.
Groovy!
What up?
Welcome in, SWS Frickie. Welcome in, Autismo. And welcome in anybody else that is chilling in the chat. Tonight we are doing the monthly follower find, which is a monthly thing that I do where one of my followers picks the game that I play. People submit games, and then when the time comes, I spin a big giant fat wheel of those submissions, and then it picks a random one at random. And this time it picked one from the homie Autismo, who has been very, very, very supportive and like friendly and awesome and knows
a lot
about JRPGs. What's up, Zelku? It'll be interesting to see which timeline you do first, because unlike something like Octopath, there's a bit more to each chapter in terms of its differences in design. Oh, I'm curious. Ms. Elku says, by the way, what? Oh, I think I know what's coming. She came in. I think I know exactly what she wants to do now, but I'll give it a minute. But yeah, he chose the game Live A Live, I think is how you pronounce it. Do you owe me a B-Day beatbox? I do. Why don't you go ahead and hit me with that redeem anytime you like, and I'll beatbox it for you. But Live Alive was made by the same people, I think, that made the Octopath Traveler games, and I love those games, as you know. Third year now. Yeah, for real. And it's similar. You have like many different storylines, I guess, but they occur in different time periods. And there was a remake that just came out recently, and this was Autismo's choice for his follower find. So let me just pop into the voice channel that I'm in currently with
Hello.
Autismo.
Oh shit! Here comes Autismo.
Welcome in, Bonesaw. It's great to see you. I think I have to do this one. Yes. Frey with your party of one. Elku, you gotta do the reward redeem to do the beatbox. So if you have the points, I'll do it. And if not, I'll still do it. But see if you can get the redeem going. And if not, then I'll just do it. Let me see if I can get this to work in the Discord. I'm gonna try going live from audio device default. That's what I want. Okay. Alright. So Autismo, whenever you're ready, you are now watching the stream. Watch the stream in the Discord because it is truly live now. And if you want to unmute yourself there and say hello, feel free. But I'm not gonna. I'm going to mute myself, but I will be able to hear you if you start talking now. So feel free to say things, Autismo, if you're there, whenever you want, or you can just sit back and watch. But I have the truly live version of the stream up for you to watch. Beatbox time for Mrs. Elku's birthday. Hey, what's up, buddy? How you doing? Can you hear me in there? Is there audio? Let's see. Let me see if he has audio. Sorry, folks. Just getting this. While we're waiting for Autismo to confirm if he can hear the stream, we're gonna go ahead and redeem.
Yeah, I could hear it.
Oh, great, perfect, awesome. So how are you doing, Autismo? It's nice to hear from you.
Doing pretty well, just chilling for now.
Nice. Thank you for joining me for tonight. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Let me get a quick birthday beatbox out of the way. That's a redeem for Mrs. Elku. She does this every year, so we're gonna make sure we do that. Ready? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Mrs. Elku.
59.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Mrs. Elku. That was just for you. Round three. Oh, yeah. I look forward to that redeem next year. All right. So tell me a little bit about Live Alive, Autismo. First of all, am I pronouncing that correctly? Because I always say, sometimes I'll say Live a Live or Live a Live. It's unclear on the pronunciation. So let's see. We're going to load up the game. The game later.
I believe the game is pronounced Live a Live. So I've seen people also just call it Live Alive, so I guess it doesn't matter.
So
in hindsight,
you can pronounce it any way you want.
So
that's pretty awesome. All right, let's load that up then. The first thing that
game is a remake of.
Yeah, tell me.
I believe it was the 98 version of the same game, which when you actually look at the game, you realize that it's pretty ambitious for what they were doing for the time.
Yeah, and it was a SNES
game. This was
right
20 plus years before Octopath even did it.
Oh my god, that's awesome. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was on Super Nintendo, right?
Yeah, it was. I believe it was also. Fun fact, it was also the first project a music composer ever made for video game music in history.
Wow.
And in fact, she even came back to do the remake soundtrack.
Wow, that's awesome. First thing I noticed straight out the gate with this game is that the music is so fucking good. Like, this shit, this song has been stuck in my head for like the past week, because as soon as I watched the trailer, this is the song that played, and I'm like, wow, let's fucking go. Also, welcome in Jake the Hobo. Ain't no live, dive, dive, dive. I don't think I need to tweak anything. I'm just gonna pop into
it. Yeah, you're gonna...
How you doing?
You're really gonna love the soundtrack for this game as a whole, because it's pretty... I would say it's pretty diverse in terms of what how she stylizes each music to represent each timeline.
Ah, I see. Is that better, Jacob? Better balance? Seems like the game volume was way up for that epic intro. Thank you for that hot tip, though, Jacob. Can you guys hear Autismo pretty okay? Is my question. We forgot to check levels. Still sound the same?
For some reason, I can't hear the game in Discord.
Oh. Let's see. You can't hear the game in Discord. Can you all hear the game music? I think it's playing in the... Huh. That's weird. But you can hear me? Oh, I know why.
Yeah,
I know why you can't hear the game. It's because I have to probably click on the... Can you hear it now? Is it playing again? Or no?
No, I can't hear it.
Weird. Can hear the game just fine. It's you. Your mic volume is set really low. Huh. I don't know. I mean, I guess I can try adjusting the volume of the...
It's kind of weird, because on my end, your mic is fine, but I can't hear the game.
That's weird. Maybe, Jacob, something's going on your end, because people are saying Elku and Autismo can hear me. It's just the game you can't hear. Okay. Huh. All right, well, let's see if we can get that fixed. Can hear the... So, on Twitch, people can hear the game, but not me, and in Discord, you can hear me, but not the game, which is super interesting to me. Let's see. Can hear you, but the game music is louder than you. Okay. We'll turn it down a little more. How about now? Is that better or the same? Jacob, I turned down the game music a little bit. Better. Okay, cool. We'll go with that. All right. Whew. We got there. So I don't think I need to tweak anything. But let's see here. Oh, I like fast text. Let's turn that on. Okay. Better butter. Oh, yeah. That buttery voice. I think we're good with, let's see, borderless window. Yeah, we want a windowed screen. I think we're okay.
Hey, little cutie.
What's up, Jelly Duck? All right, now we're going to start a new game, Autismo. I'm sorry, I don't know how to fix the sound. I can work on that, though. Let me see if I can actually work on that right now. I'll stop my stream for you, but then I'll start it up again. Oh, you know what it is? I know what it is. I think I have to turn on the virtual cam again. All right. So now if I share to you... We're just going to hear this lovely track loop endlessly, because it's a pretty dope track. We're going to go default and say... All right, now tell me if you can hear the game, Autismo. And if not, I'm gonna get started. But let me know if you can hear it or not. All right, let's see. Ooh. This game's on my game clearing list, but it's on that maybe pile because I got a bunch of other RPGs on my list this year. Oh yeah, Jacob, true. Select a character. Oh my god. Oh, so much pressure. This is just like Octopath. And looks like each one is a different time period. Twilight of Edo, Japan. Imperial China. Present day. Prehistory. The Wild West. The near future. The distant future. Oh, this is so cool. Autismo, do you have a character that you recommend I start with?
That's a bit of a tricky one, because each, I will call them chapters to make it simple. Each one is designed differently from each other, where sometimes it leans more on the gameplay, sometimes it leans more on its narrative. It's a bit hard to recommend a specific one.
Do you have one that... Yeah, go ahead.
I think either Imperial China, prehistory, or feudal or Edo Japan is probably the better choices to go with if you want to see what the gameplay is like.
Okay. Let's do... So you said present day, prehistory, and feudal Japan? Like Twilight of Edo Japan?
Yes.
That one looks kind of fun. Let's do that one.
Yeah.
It is an age of strife and bloodshed, which threatens to consume an entire nation. In the shadows cast by the fires of chaos, a shinobi is given a mission of paramount importance. Into a castle filled with deadly traps and wary enemies he must venture, that he might free a prisoner of singular talents. Yet will the shinobi carry out his task with a merciful heart, or will he put his every enemy to the sword? Well, we're about to find out. Let's play this chapter. I played the SNES version, looks fun, but the fan translation is kind of messy. Oh, is it not? It was never released in the U.S.? Mm-mm. Oh, damn. Atmospheric. I love the 2D, 3D style. Not released in US, 1994. Yeah. Whoa. I don't know what is happening.
You've kept me waiting long enough. Speak.
Ooh.
I am pleased to report that after a struggle.
Nada, could you read books for me to sleep to? I will. Yeah, absolutely. The OG SNES version never came to the U.S. I think it was because the SNES was on its way out and it wasn't worth the production cost. Oh, yeah. 98 is definitely... Or 94? Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
We finally managed to capture our quarry.
Quarry.
So, he's mine at last.
O-D-E-U.
I've added the finishing touches to my puppet too, my lord.
Man, it's already happening. Connection issues on my end. Aw, Tismo, I'm so sorry. Well, you can just watch the stream, man. That's fine. If you want to hear the actual game.
All that remains is to peel back the man's skin and replace his internal components.
You have the book audio voice I could sleep to. Just relax and fall asleep, Mrs. Elku. Rest your weary eyes, close them, and lean back into the sleep. Everything will be fine. It's basically like calm Palpatine. That's that voice. Okay.
We shall begin work tomorrow at dawn.
Very good.
Allow me to attend to his soul, my lord, for I do miss the taste of sweet, noble essence.
Very well.
Delicious essence.
Soon the fires of war shall rage across Japan once more. And all will be mine.
I should do an audiobook in the Bantha voice.
Call me Ismail.
Hey, he's back. Oh.
My lord.
A little late, aren't we?
I am ready to depart.
Are you now? And what would become of the Emma Shinobi were you to fall? Huh? No, I will not allow it. Indeed, I would sooner go myself than send you.
I keep forgetting about my eyebrow piercing and snag it every once in a while. It hurts. Oh, that sucks. You should talk to Stabo about that. I bet that happens to him a lot. He's got, I think, 3 facial piercings. Facial piercings? That's hard to say.
My lord.
Millard.
Perhaps there is another.
then, who might be up to the task?
This is good, because I don't have to read this stuff. As much as I enjoy the voice acting.
My lord, surely there is more to some written capable of carrying out such a
Oh, I love the hidden commands of, like, typing yeah and generating that sound. That scared the crap out of me, and it was great. Surely there's no other shinobi capable of carrying out such a difficult mission.
Unless, yes, there is another who may suffice.
He's been talking to me about them? Yeah.
His training is incomplete, yet he shows great promise.
Uh-huh. And his name?
Not a one.
My lord, the youth is called.
Oh, we'll call him that for sure. We'll stick to character names. Oboru Maru. Confirm.
As you will recall.
Ah, yes. That one I know. Go and fetch him, then.
There is no need, for he has shadowed me from the first.
Hey.
Impressive.
Oh, I forgot. He doesn't say the name. Because you have to enter the name.
Now then. Yours is a secret mission of the greatest import.
Jacob says, okay, so I was wrong. The sales of the original version didn't meet expectations because Final Fantasy IV came out earlier and they chose not to push for worldwide release. That makes sense.
Are you familiar with the details?
Yes,
my lord.
Yeah, and it was... It's then been that go, way for 20 plus years since they still didn't think it would be appropriate to move the game over to the West knowing that it wasn't going to do well.
Mm. Wow, long time.
But it was kind of surprising that they even chose to remake this game and give it a West release.
Yeah, technique. I mean, I guess it did really well then. It goes to show how well it did, like, overseas and stuff, you know. Secret technique. Shadowed Self. Cool.
Should you find yourself beset by enemies, it will serve you well.
Press X. But not going for a worldwide release helped it in the long run because it gained a cult following. Hell yeah.
For with it, you can melt into the shadows and become invisible.
It has a cult following, just like me.
We haven't a moment to lose. You must master the skill during your mission. I have no doubt you will. You always were a fast learner.
Friends, this is a good time just to let you know Nightbot is reminding you that on June 5th, I'm going to be doing a charity stream for Rainbow Railroad. I'm going to be playing Celeste for 8 hours and seeing how many levels of Celeste I can beat in 8 hours. So you can go to that form. There are two ways to donate. You can donate the day of, or you could also donate the day after. So I guess there's three ways. Or you can pledge an amount, and then however many levels of Celeste I beat that day multiplies your pledged amount and you donate that amount. And if you want to pledge, you just follow that link. Nada, you don't have a cult following, you just have a cult. Nice. Okay. So we have good to luck. Master the skill while we play. Getting a chance to use that shadowed self.
You bear a heavy burden, young shinobi. The fate of the Emma, nay, the fate of all Japan, shall be shaped by your deeds tonight.
No pressure.
So, every chapter has, like, specific, what do I call it, it's designed in a certain way for you to do certain objectives in each one to see whether you succeed in them or not. But in the case of, Japan, there's one of two ways you could go about doing the game. You could either roll for a full pacifist run where you don't kill any innocent, or you go for a full genocide run where you kill everyone.
I'll try passive.
This is the tale of the greatest of the Emperor.
That said, doing each one is a bit tricky because there's like certain things you feel like you have to know ahead of time, otherwise you just end up locking yourself out of certain moments.
Hmm. Gotcha.
But if you were to do either one in completion, you would get something special at the end.
Oh, cool. Twilight of Edo Japan, The Infiltrator. So this is like chapter one of this timeline, right?
Actually, I would say every game only has one chapter because the stories themselves aren't that long.
Gotcha.
Like, if I had to give an estimate, I'd say each one is maybe like an hour and a half long at most.
Gotcha. Perfect. Maybe we'll finish this one tonight, or we'll get close to the end. That's about all the time I have for tonight. Wish I had more, but, you know, life do be like that. But I'm having fun, and I'm glad you're here. I always enjoy when people can join me on the mic for follower finds, because they basically are holding my hands. All right. The radar are located in the bottom right corner of the screen. What? Sorry?
I don't know. I was going to let you do all this on your own.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, sure. That's also true. Some people are just like, nah, I'm not going to do that. The radar located in the bottom right corner of the screen can be used to identify unexplored areas and guide you to your current objective. Okay, so the gray is a route to an explored area, route to an explored area, route to current objective, okay. Can be turned off. If you wish to quit the current chapter and play a different one, access settings and select, ooh, play a different chapter, fun. Could we do that at some point? Like, could we save it and then try a different one? If we wanted?
Yes, this is a new feature in the remake. In the original, you essentially were stuck with the specific chapter you ended up with.
So wow.
If you wanted to try something else in the remake, you can do that.
Yes, I would love to do that. Let's play this for a little bit, though.
So you could
I could what? Resume from last.
Say you could, in theory, try out maybe half of every chapter in this stream if you wanted to.
Okay. When in doubt, consider the Ode Castle maps. Let me know when I get about halfway through this one. Oboru Maru carries with him a rough sketch of Ode Castle and its various buildings. Press that button to view this sketch and confirm your present location. I remember our game together. Me too, Mizelku, where you and I hung out while I played Little Nightmares 2. That was fun. That was a fun follower find. Oh, wow. Oh, this is cool. Oh, and this is the X is the hiding himself thing. I see. Is there a run button? Slip past the guards or confront them. Obamaro can execute the Shadow Self technique while infiltrating Ode Castle. By holding X, he can hide himself and any allies from wandering enemies until the danger has passed. Still my fave games? Yeah. So, do they, like, move? I see, they move. When they notice you, they move closer. Oh, and then you have to, like, go past them when they're not looking.
Probably get moving at some point.
I'll see. I'll wait till they're not looking. Let's see. Go the other way. Oh, come on, dude. Stealth. Uh-oh. He's on top of me. Maybe that doesn't matter. Go away from the door. Get out of here. There's nothing here. Move away. Oh boy, that looks bad. Oh no. Intruder! Ah well. Now we gotta fight. I did my best. Okay, first fight of the game. A charge gauge will appear above allies and enemies that are readying actions. Once this gauge has been completely filled, they will execute the action. Hi, Lurky. Thanks for the lyrics, Dabo. You're a good guy. All right, cool. When controlling abilities in battle, you may choose one of several commands. Abilities, attacks, heal, other abilities, items, use items, pass, switch to another ally, wait, allow enemy and ally charge gauges to fill, flee, attempt to escape. When selecting abilities and items for use, the area of effect will be displayed. Use this guide to ensure your intended targets will be affected. Okay. When an ally's HP is reduced to zero, they will no longer be able to fight. Restoring any amount of HP will put them back in action. Be warned that if all allies are incapacitated, the game will end. Incapacitated allies damage further, they'll be immediately dismissed from the field. Dismissed characters cannot rejoin via healing or any other method. Wow. So when a character dies, they die. Like, you can't bring him back? Like, there's no life spell? Let's try that one. Fireflies, wait!
If they get knocked down, you can bring them back. But if they get hit after that, then they remain dead.
Gotcha. I see. Oh, so now my gauge is all the way full, so I can use cross flare.
I guess it's worth highlighting that if a character is knocked down, you don't actually have a revival spell. You can just use basic healing spells to bring them back.
Gotcha. I think we won. You are victorious. Nice. We got a shrimp rice ball. Hell yeah. Okay. Lives taken, too. So now I can't get the achievement because I killed somebody? Is that kind of what you're saying? Like, I can kill everybody or nobody.
Ruin the path of this run.
Well, so now let's go...
You could still do genocide.
Yeah, let's go. Let's do genocide. Why not? Alright, let's see. Alright, so I can't reach...
Nada went around and mass murdered an entire group of people off because they looked at him wrong.
Pretty much. Oh, and then you move after... I see. So you attack, and then your character moves to a better spot. Or no, you don't move. So, when do you move... When does your character move? Let's see.
When is your character's turn? Just choose to move around, it does take up a bit of I guess you would say the action gauge.
Oh, got it.
You would even move as well.
I see.
Moving doesn't
expend. Oh man, I miss him.
I think something this game also doesn't tell you, but it's nice to know that positioning does determine damage, so back attacks do more damage than.
Oh, really? Okay. Punch! Oh man, he's dead! You were defeated. Well, so now I'm gonna start over and try the pacifist run.
You have a long ways to go.
Oh my god, do I have to sit through all this again? Auto advance. Let's try that.
My lord.
Or no, skip. Skip is what I want. Yeah. Okay.
For future reference, you can save at any time in the game once you start controlling your character.
Got it. Oh, I think I just skipped a cutscene. Oh, I see. So I feel like it auto saved, maybe. All right. Well, whatever. Let's. No, I want to kill those guys. What's going on with chat? I hope we're still alive. I feel like we're still alive. Let's go. Alright, so they're over there now. So if I move a little, like move here, and do Firefly's Wake. You are live, alive. Thanks, Bonesaw. Bonesaw says we are live, alive. I see. The little green gauge is the hell. How do you heal? Do I use those, like, shrimp rice ball things to heal?
For now, you kind of have to. Some characters have the means of healing themselves. Others don't. Although Amaro doesn't, so you will have to rely on items.
Gotcha. Makes sense to me. Oh my god.
Now then, let's go over the hourly passwords once more.
Hourly passwords?
Mountain! River! Potato! an imposter! Take him away!
Uh-oh, he didn't say river. That's a classic river potato mix-up.
This method allows us to tell friend from phone with ease.
What?
Hang on.
Right. Back to your posts. And if you hear the bell, you know what to do. Sir.
Potato. All right, let's quote-unquote sneak our way through. Hayati said there are two, River and Origin, I think. The Ode Clan uses a password system as a defense against infiltration by spies and shinobi. When confronted by a guard, you will need to say either River or Origin to avoid combat. Every time you hear a bell rung, the password will change, so pay attention to make sure you don't say it wrong. Ooh, that's a cool mechanic. I see you, shinobi! Let's go, retainer. Ooh, this guy looks tough. Let's start with a Firefly Wake. Why not? Ooh, 8 damage for his Firefly Wake? Damn. He's just charging. Oh no, he's charging into me. That's what that is. Yikes. Okay. Let's see. Oh, and I take damage from being on fire tiles. I see. Okay. So it looks like I should probably heal. Let's use a shrimp rice ball.
This will do.
Oh, and I probably should have moved. Oh well. Whoa, what does that all do?
Those are buffs that you get from using the item. It essentially increases your stats by a bit.
I see, his yellow thing went up. All right, so we'll try... God, he's resistant to everything. Water Sprout? Let's try Water Sprout. Oh, there we go. That's a good attack. I get to go again? Oh, cool. Let's do another Water Sprout. That seemed to work pretty well. Hey! Did that kill him? No, he's close to death, though.
As am I.
Water tile damage! Ugh! You take water damage? Ugh! Alright. We're gonna go one last water tile to end this guy. Come on, don't miss.
The waters I command.
Boom! Don't take damage.
Be at peace.
Yes! I thought that would suck if you took damage at the end of the fight. Oh!
Life's taken 5.
This is really cool.
I guess for future reference, if you wanted to do full genocide, I would avoid killing any and all the women because of something specific later on. But then after that, you could just kill everyone else.
Got it. Killing you will bring me great honor. Okay. Oh crap, you know what? I didn't heal with my rice ball yet. Ugh. Oh, but I'm back to full health. Cool. Wow, he's so far away. Or she? I don't know. Let's try... Vulnerable. Ooh, yeah, let's try that. I like that it tells you the weaknesses.
Now come the fireflies.
He's sort of... She's sort of vulnerable. God, so do you have to, like, move and then cast it when you're far away? Like, oh, I think I know it. Yeah, okay, so we have to, like, move far away and then cast the Firefly thing here? I think that's what we do. Or, no, we have to do it here.
You can only cast it in the areas where the piles are blue.
Got it. Okay. So, I have to move a little closer.
Other ones just kind of show you how far it's gonna go.
Alright, well, let's try that shit again. Or let's see if we can get... No, we have to get closer. Oh, now we can do Shadow Slash. Well, let's do the vulnerable one. Can you also just, like, attack, or is it, like, only abilities?
I believe it's only abilities you
okay.
can perform.
That's fine. We're gonna eat a shrimp rice ball. We're gonna be good. Hey! Bring up those stats, baby. Get damaged by fire, baby. Haha, sucker. Sorry, I was doing eat G finances. Wow. What? What are you talking about, Bonesaw? Alright, let's do Firefly's Wake. This is gonna kill him for sure. Bye. Eat my shrimpolds. Oh, I think he was trying to say I was doing finances, and then he was trying to say eat my shrimpolds. Got it. Well, Ponesaw, you've somehow made that more confusing, and it already was confusing. Life's taken six. Intruder! That's me. A lot of combat happening in this run. Oh, he's weak against Firefly. Firefly's weak.
Let's do it.
You know, I like that it's only abilities, because when I do RPGs, I tend to only do abilities anyways. Oh, shit! Fuck, that was awesome. That guy just fucking disintegrated. He was like, here I come! Spontaneous combustion. Lives taken seven. What do you want? I see through your ruse.
I see through your ruse.
Clever child. Meow. So I'm supposed to not kill the women?
Yeah. You could always choose to run from a fight if you either feel you can't handle it or if you're trying to avoid doing.
So do you suggest I not kill this person and like run away if I'm doing this type of run? Or still try to kill her?
Yes, if you're going full genocide, it's better to avoid the women for now.
Okay.
But there will come a time where you can go back and eliminate all of them afterwards.
Okay. I managed to escape. Whoa, that's a cool running away motion. I've only had one payment on my car due, and I've already paid off more than 3 months. Whoop, whoop. Nice job, Ponesaw. Okay. Wow, that tip came in hot and then left. It ghosted as quickly as it got here. It was like five paragraphs, and then it was like, nope.
You can look up in the office.
What? I can make it an option.
I believe
to like,
if you wanted to look at the tip, you can just look at them in the options menu.
Nah, no time. I will respect its need to bounce quickly. So here's a question. How do you not take fire damage when you use this ability? Do you have to like move and then cast it?
Unfortunately for Bobo here, he does have to move after he casts it.
I see. So you will take damage if you use that spell.
Yes.
Makes sense.
That said, there are accessories you can wear later on that mitigate or even heal you for taking tile damage like this.
I see. Interesting. Well, let's fucking do another one of those.
Now come the fireflies.
I have trouble discerning where the playable area is. Oh my god! We're gonna wolf down a shrimp rice ball right away.
This will do.
This will do.
I like that the heel noise is also the Mario coin noise.
Hello.
Spicy boy Charles! Imagine lighting the entire battlefield on fire and still missing! That would be something. Welcome in, Spicy Boy Charles. Good to see you. I feel like when I say your name, I have to give it that little accent. Charles. How's your day going, dude? Good to see you.
Be at peace.
Be at peace.
Oh, we leveled up. And we got a fucking scroll. Oh, no. A Fujin scroll. That's how you pronounce it in my mind. Ding, 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 ding.
What's interesting about Live Alive is that although the levels can reach beyond level 20, 20 is theoretically the max level you ever need to go to.
Yeah? Oh, we got a new ability, Firefall. Okay. Sure, let's try it. Oh, damn! That's a good ability. And we're going again? Oh, this guy is fucked. Let's try Firefall again. So I've never had to use... I'm noticing that the yellow gauge is not going down at all.
Fires I command.
When does that go down? Like, when you move? It
Okay, so I guess it's because Obermaru is fast, so you don't notice it, but certain abilities requires you to charge up before it can be used.
I see.
If you're a slow-ish character, the yellow gauge kind of turns red and it will fill up depending on how long it's taking for you to charge it.
Gotcha. Alright, let's fight these fucking guys. Password. Mountain. I'm gonna say potato, because I wanna fight him. Imposter! It's going swell. Glad it's five. Nice. If you get the same car as I do, one cool perk is that you're stuck, stopped in traffic. You can set it to turn off the engine. It calculates how much gas you save from it. For every 20 minutes that's in effect, it calculates you save 1/10 of a gallon. Oh, that's cool. Alright. Let's try our firefall ability on these fucking guys. Nice.
Be at peace.
Yeah, I'm gonna light you on fire, but be at peace. All right, Rogen. Can we reach him now with this? Oh, no. Gotta go a little closer. Firefall. Got him. What else you got, Rogen? Nothing. You're about to die. You will die a terrible, terrible death.
The fires I command.
Got him.
Be at peace.
Victorious. 12 lives. Don't kill the women. Okay. Don't kill the women. What's here? Ah, secret way. Hey, dude.
Seize him!
Oh my god, this looks tougher than... You are no match for a shinobi of the Ode clan. Oh yeah? Watch me. Oh, actually, these guys look pretty tough. We're gonna do... Oh man, they're not vulnerable to anything, but this is my strongest attack, so let's try this out. Firefall. Miss? Oh boy, this looks kind of bad. That was such a puny little bounce noise. Alright, we're gonna not miss this time. Because we're gonna go here. We're gonna go here on the guy that we missed. Hey, there we go. One of them is almost dead. Yikes. I feel like I should probably do this again and try to kill this guy. I think, let's try that out. Hey! Now this guy's probably gonna attack. Or not! Okay. Well, can we take him down? Let's see. Nice! That was lucky. I don't know. I didn't think I'd win. I mean, of course, that's not a ton of gas, but if you live in a place like the one in which you live and know it's going to add up fast, and it's a pretty quick restart, too. Like, barely enough time to move my foot to the velocitator by the time it started up again. Nice. Great. Let's see. Stay back. Oh, now I fight him. Crap. I was not prepared for this. Well, I should... Oh, I'm healed up already. I like that it heals you every battle.
Yeah, it's pretty nice. It saves from you having to remember, oh, where I took damage.
Yeah, right. Totally. Wow! That guy got fucked! He's super dead. That was, like, so short, and I got a top knot. Whatever that is. It's like a helmet?
It's the helmet you can equip.
Oh, let's check out the menu. Oh, yeah, let's equip a helmet. Top knot. Anything else? Any relics? Any shirts? Any... Same old deal? Yeah, okay, cool. Well, we got a helmet. That's pretty good. What's
hey,
up?
Hey.
How's it going, Zero Sacrifice? Let's pause for a minute and give Zero Sacrifice a shout out.
He's a cool dude.
We've always been ages since I've last seen you.
We were talking about you today on Zero Stream. Oh, my favorite story? Nice. That's good. We'll give Zero a quick shout-a-rooney. We're going to do it with this sweet music playing in the background. Let's see. Where's the shout-out theater? Oh, where are you? There you are. All right, so we're going to do shout-out theater for Zero. What do you got for us, bud? Let's see.
Everybody, be prepared. Yo, I seriously thought that was part of the intro. I was like, whoa.
Bam, bam, bam. Nice. Everybody go follow Zero. He's such an awesome dude. He's so fun to watch. He's a good watch if you're just, like, work lurking and you need to get stuff done. He's also such a, like, nice guy to chat with and, like, really positive and friendly and shit. So go give him a follow. He's a good guy. All right. Back to feudal Japan. Thanks, man. Oh, of course. Absolutely. All right. We're going for a non-pacifist run. Mountain.
Potato.
I'm always going to say potato. Would you say we're about halfway through this storyline, Autismo?
Oh, no.
No.
Like...
All right. We'll probably just we'll probably just play this storyline then.
Fires, I command.
I know you probably haven't played a lot, but what's your thoughts so far? It's fucking great. I love it. It's so fun. I'll probably... Ooh, Poison Mist. That's a new one. Let's poison this dude. This is a game that's so good, I'll probably play it off stream.
Be at peace.
In my own storyline, and keep the storyline going on stream. What is a great white? Catching a great white on stream. What does that mean? Nobody's here. I like that you can see all the can you see all the enemies in the other storylines too? I wonder. I like to explore everything, so you're gonna have to deal with that. Who's this? Oh, cool, we're gonna fight a merchant. He looks terrified. All right. Let's try, we're obviously gonna do Firefall. I do fishing streams sometimes. I got one coming up at the end of the month also. Oh, cool. I didn't know that. That's awesome. Catching a great white shark. Wow, that guy ate it.
Be at peace.
That's so cool, Zero. I didn't know that. What time of day do you... Yeah. Yeah, new thing I've been trying. That's cool. Your life is forfeit. It's random right now, honestly. Yeah. Might be kind of cool to check out another storyline, Autismo. So, which one do you think would be... If I save it now and come back to... It'll start from wherever I saved it, right? Believe that's the case. Ooh, that didn't do much damage. But he is poisoned.
Poison damage.
That's not too bad. It's the first time someone's attacked me in a long time.
The fires I command.
Oh yeah. Victorious. And it heals you after the battle. God, that's so good. I do feel like I'm playing on easy mode. It's a slice of Castella cake. Oh, nice. Castellella. All right, let's see. Let's try going this way. What's up, buddy? We're gonna fight you.
I guess I should have also said this castle is pretty big.
So yeah.
I'd be surprised if you just ended up wandering around everywhere.
Do you think if we save it and check out another storyline, we'll start exactly where we saved it?
Or do we have to get to a save point? Okay, cool. So after this fight, let's check out another storyline just for fun.
It's funny enough, if you save, go to a different chapter, then come back, but you save near an enemy, that enemy will just respawn.
Oh, shit. So that guy's gonna come back. That's fine. We'll just fight him again. All right, so we'll go to options or settings and save. Cool. And now we can do, what is it? Return to chapter select. Oh, yeah. All right, let's check out another character. I want to get at least two in for this stream. So you said present day or what was the other one? Prehistory?
Prehistory.
Let's check out prehistory.
In a forgotten era before kings and kingdoms, a young man comes of age and is given permission by his tribe's stern elder to go forth and hunt, together with his best friend, Gori. Bereft of spoken words, they rely on their senses to survive, in particular a powerful sense of smell. Guided by their noses, they track game and find shelter, and learn much of the world and its dangers.
Prehistory, played this chapter?
Yes.
Game says is true. There is no dialogue.
Oh, really?
At all.
Oh my god, really?
Three.
This is great!
Compared to every other chapter. A lot of cons and such.
Oh my god. This is so good! Wow. So he has to find a lady? Looks like. Oh my god, this is great.
Kind of what I was talking about when I said each one is different from the other.
Oh, this is super different.
This game was pretty ambitious for its time.
Yeah, super different. This one usually makes me chuckle. It's already made me laugh. This is pretty good. Wow. She got away. Do you like the remake more than the original? Seems pretty tight. Oh, that's our guy, I think, or no. Did she just like, is she disguised? This is pretty awesome. Huh? Shum. Word. Uh-oh, what happened to him? Let's see. All right, cool. Cutscene. It is a rocky desert. Nice. Very deserty desert. Wow, that woolly mammoth has kind of like the 90s like mushroom cut. That's pretty awesome actually. What?
Well, that makes sense considering when the
it's the 90s. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Wow, that was definitely intentional then. Every childlike character just needs a mushroom cut. Whoa! Look out. So, like, after you do all the chapters, I'm assuming, like, these characters, like, join each other in, like, parties and stuff. You don't want to spoil anything. That's fine. You don't have to.
You'll see when. Yeah.
Prehistory, the first. Word. Let's get into it. Pogo. Yeah, we'll call him that. It's a good name. Oh, word. Wake up, dude. Wow. It looks like an incredibly a surly Donkey Kong is our partner right now. You obtained a stick. Nice. Should we equip that? Nice. Did that? Was that better? No, bone is actually better. Wow, so we found a weapon that was worse. Sweet. Okay.
Funny detail is that to go along with the design of each timeline, every item you get in each timeline has a description that is unique to that timeline. So, the shrimp balls you find in Edo, Japan are described in such a way that makes sense in that timeline, while the bones and sticks in this one are just grunting noises or just basic words.
Oh, that's awesome! So the descriptions are, like, the same as the type of dialogue in the... Oh, that's so good. Wow, that's cool. Pelt and a hard rock.
This timeline does. All those items you're picking up, those are actually crafting materials.
Oh, really? Okay. Well, we have a pelt, though. We can equip that.
You can take them.
Oh, and he gets stuff.
You can take all these for a guy.
I see.
Does.
Okay. Well, that's good to know.
Yep.
3, 5. Oh shit. Was I supposed to pay attention to that? Which one is which? Left? I don't really know what I'm doing. Let's see. Wow, this is so good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What? Oh, I lost. I'm supposed to pick the one that has more. I see.
Yeah.
Well, let's try that again. Okay. I'm feeling ready this time. We can do it.
Another variation of this.
Okay.
Yeah, whatever one he points to, that's the one you're looking for. So in this case, you're looking for the one that has more.
Okay. I'm pretty sure it's the one on the right this time. So let's see. Let's see, chat. Did I do it right? I did it!
Yes! Yes!
Nice.
Awesome. I obtained a stick and a bone and a beast horn and a beast fang and a pelt, a set of dried skins, a hard rock. Damn, son! We're gonna get our craft on. Nailed
you
it.
You could sit here and play the minigame that you can just grind on crafting materials for stuff.
Yeah, that seems like a really good way to, like, just get a shitload of stuff. Oh, a pelt. Excellent. Okay. Oh, can he get any... Oh, a bee's fang. Yeah. Ooh, let's get the info for that. Damage resistance to... Okay. Cool. Nice.
I think bee's fang is just a simple attack boost.
Cool. This is, like, really awesome. I'm really enjoying this game. It's super fun. Oh, hey! What are these guys doing? What the fuck? I don't even know what they did. Fire is hot. Confirmed. A bone. A stick. Can I equip anything for this other guy? Alright, that's fine.
Sadly, the only thing he gets is pout.
That's okay.
To be fair, he does have good stats.
Yeah.
So it makes up for the loss.
He can't wear a helmet because his unibrow slash... His unibrow that turns into his, like, mohawk or whatever, it just wouldn't fit, you know? Oh, cool. We scared that guy. You know, the director of this game went on to direct Chrono Trigger and Parasite Eve. Oh, really? That's cool.
Yeah, some people... Well, some people say that this is the greatest episode of Chrono Trigger would do. In terms of, like timeline stuff.
By combining two different items, you can create new, potentially useful ones. Experiment with different combinations and see what happens.
Hello.
What's up, Ray? How you doing? Bone plus stick. Or no, hard rock plus stick? Let's try that. Let's see if we can get something. Wow! Wow, what, Stabbo? Literally just got home from work. Damn. Yeah. Man, work is tough. You obtained a strong axe. Let me ask you a question. Now if you do that plus... What the fuck is that thing? A mop? What is he saying? I can get one or the other?
I think the thing on the right is supposed to be you saying, no, I don't want to make any more stuff.
Oh, got it. Okay. Yeah, let's make something else. Let's see if we can do that. Strong axe, but sword symbol. For real. So now, let's see, if I do... What if I do bone and stick? Maybe that will make something. Look who the cat girl dragged in. Hi, Ray! A horn spear. Interesting. So you just kind of have to fuck around. Alright, so now I think I'm done crafting. Cool. That's kind of a fun element. And that crafting element doesn't exist in the feudal Japan one, right? Like, there's nothing, no equivalent to that.
That's... It is not. It is exclusive to prehistory.
That is so cool.
In fact, everything you would find in each timeline is exclusive to that timeline.
Got it. Well, damn, dude. That is pretty sweet. Wow, we just got a super sick thing. The horn spear. Nope. And once again, sadly, he cannot equip anything. Oh, each story has, like, its own little thing, which is super cool. Someone dropped off a bunch of books at work, and I got a big-ass Legend of Zelda book. Ooh, details, Ray.
Club when you have Fist of Steel.
Whoa, what the hell? Yeah, that's how I would react. If somebody fucking disappeared in front of me. He has the ability that the ninja has. He has shadowed self. A Zelda book? Yeah. Is it the Hyrule Historia? That one? That one is pretty good. Oh, yeah! Excellent. Yeah, Hyrule Historia is dope. They have a couple volumes now. I only have the first one, but they have another one that's like... they have one that talks about the stories of Zelda. That's the first one. Got it for free? Oh, damn. That's such a good book. What? What is he saying? He's saying probably that we have to go talk to the elder. Big win. Absolute big win, for sure. There's also... What'd you say?
He doesn't want you touching the food.
Oh, gotcha. Talk to the elder. Okay. Alright, let's go talk to the elder. Talk, in quotes. I like how some of them don't do anything and they're just like, eh. That's pretty awesome. What's this way? I'm just gonna. Yeah, alright. I see your Spider-Man angry face. I'll come see you. Yeah, Hyrule Historia is dope, especially if you're into the Zelda games. It talks about the chronology of the games and the stories at length. You need food. Yeah, it's a really awesome book. And then if you still want more, there's another compendium that talks about like the items and artifacts and stuff like that, I believe. Another Hyrule History book that's like red. Go that way. All right, I will. Well, this is such happy music. I think we have to get food now. I think now we're allowed to take the food. Let's see. Let's find out.
Actually, you're gonna go hunt for food.
Yeah, we can't just steal that guy's food, that's for sure. Up we go.
What's over here?
Yeah, let's try going this way. Hey, Elder. Yep. Whoa, a cloud! A cloud of doom approaches. So for those that joined after we started the storyline, this is Live Alive, or Alive Alive. None of us really know how to pronounce it, including Autismo. But basically, this is a game where there are many characters, and you can choose any character you want and play their chapter, and each chapter is from a different timeline. And in this chapter, we're in prehistory, and there is no dialogue, so they communicate with, like, symbols and movements and stuff. It's pretty awesome. We're playing as this caveman named Pogo. Yep. Another cloud! But I thought you killed that cloud. I like how the cloud has a shadow.
They're kind of showing you the scene again in case you didn't catch it. So if you want to progress, just talk to the elder.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. Ah, I see. Oh, they're showing you, like, you have to get into a fight and get the... Got it. Cool.
Yeah.
Nah. All right, let's talk to the elder. But I talked to the... Oh, is he going to do it again? Or no, he's getting out of the way.
No.
All right, cool. So now we can just move along. Can you still not hear the game, by the way, Autismo?
Unfortunately, no.
Bummer.
In fact, interestingly, when you pulled up the... When you pulled up the shout-out, I couldn't hear that either.
Oh, interesting. But you can hear me. That's so weird. Pogo has an extraordinary sense of smell that allows him to hunt game and find other things of interest. Press X to reveal scent clouds in the vicinity. So when I press X, those little...
Well, this is kind of interesting. Yeah. See, prehistory doesn't have random encounters. Rather, every encounter is there, but you have to look for it.
I see. Oh, that's cool. Okay. Oh, so then we get into a fight after we find the... Oh my god, we're fighting little dogs! Alright, this is the combat, folks. So we have Bang Bash and Pow Kick, but we're not anywhere near any enemies, so let's get close to some enemies. That's so cool. Let's try Pow Kick on that one. But the range will be all of them, I believe? Or no, just that one. Okay. Okay, so he's a little different. He can only attack... His abilities only hit one at a time. Scareface. Hurt many, bad with surprise boo. I love the descriptions. Let's try... Oh, shit. Shit's over. If you move too much, they attack, I see. Okay. I'll try Scareface. That's awesome. Ooh, a threat. I'm glad I played the other chapter before this one, because if I were to start out with two characters, I'd be thoroughly confused. Let's try Pow Kick. Whoa, shit. Booted. The good thing is these feral dogs don't do too much damage. Let's try Bang Slap. Slap! Excellent. Oh, stop threatening me. All right, we're gonna try... Oh, we gotta move again? All right, we'll try Bang Bash now for him. This dog is fucked. Boom! You are victorious! Nice. And then we heal again, right? After that battle. Itchy butt. I know, he scratched his ass. Nice. Zero, it's been a while since you've been here, but we have a lot of fun sound commands. If you check out the about section, they are listed there. What did he say? Oh, we have to hunt more.
I think he wants you to hunt down every
okay.
Enemy here for me.
Wait, but I'm smelling him.
For the record, the scent doesn't just pick up. Yeah, the scent doesn't just.
Oh, it just it picks up other people.
It picks up other things as well.
Got it. Okay. Well, but that guy. Wait a minute. But that is that guy was just hiding. Or no, that's the smell of the elder. That's what I'm smelling. I'm smelling the elder. Aha! An enemy is afoot. But where is it?
The little puff clouds on the floor.
Oh, you gotta fight them.
After you find them.
I see. There it is. So you have to. Oh, so you sniff. And then you go into the cloud, and then you fight a bad guy. Got it. All right, let's try... Bang Bash. Boom. Wow, eviscerated. Their attacks are, like, pretty wimpy. Damn. That guy is strong. Pow kick. Yeah, shit's over. Bye. You are victorious. Yeah, Zero, feel free to pick one of those sound commands at random and see what it does. We also have an ability now in the channel to redeem, we have a reward redeem where you can pick a sound command and I will create a slow or fast version of it, which has been a lot of fun.
Jeez!
That's right, Ponsa. Right on cue. Hey, can someone, we gotta get a exclamation point Daisy normal so we know what that sounds like. Hydrate? I will hydrate. Let's get the regular Daisy one.
Watch where you send it!
Ugh. And then we also have... Oh yeah, cooldown. We got it. Thanks, Autismo. I gotta fix this cooldown thing. I'm in the process of moving all of my sound commands over to StreamerBot, which has no cooldown. But Streamlabs chatbot auto-cools down, and it's like the most annoying thing ever.
What? I was fed, and then I will take a nap now, and then I think I'm gonna call some hospitals.
Yes, that's the one that Ray made. Oh, you want to do G's slow? All right, hold on. No, we're gonna get your whelp in there.
Well, it was fun. I'm gonna go take a nap now, and then I think I'm gonna call some hospitals.
All right, so Autismo, we have a redeem to do a slow G's sound command for Ponsa, so we're gonna do that real quick. Let me get that loaded up. Hold on. Let's see. We've got this happy music in the background is making my day. G's. There it is. So you want a slow G's. Okay, cool. We can do a slow G's. I think that's the fast version.
Jeez.
Yeah, we're not gonna do that. We want slow. Let's try slow.
Jeez.
Oh my god!
Wow! That's so good! Alright, hold on. Hang on, I gotta get it loaded up now into... Oh shit, did I just save over the... Oh my god, I think I just saved... Holy shit, hold on. Hold on.
Jeez.
I think that it... Oh fuck, you know what, Bonesaw? I think that it, I think I saved it as... So I think now if you just type exclamation point G's, I think it is now just gonna play the slow one. I think I fucked up. Let's see, hang on.
Jeez.
No, okay, all right. It's still okay. All right, hold on. We're getting a lot of messages from the software that I use to create the, let me try that again, hold on.
Jeez.
Okay, now we're gonna try loading in the slow version of G's. It's pretty awesome, right, Ponza? Hold on. Let's see. Speed and pitch. Okay, so now we're gonna apply that and then save that file. God, it's so good. All right. I'm gonna save it as G's slow. Save. I think now I have to... Sorry, Atisma, just give me one sec here. I hope you're just rocking out to this music in the background, Atisma. That would make me really happy if you were.
Oh, I ain't.
Oh, you ain't? Okay. Sound. Sound files. Let's get a new one loaded. Let's see. Fast and slow, geez. There it is. And now we're gonna create the command. We're almost there, folks. Alright. Alright, Ponesaw, it should be all loaded up. If you want to do exclamation point G's slow, it has been added. So anytime you're ready, drop it. And if it doesn't work, I'll drop it for you. That's on T-Smo, beat you to it. Oh, it's so good. Thank you, Ponesaw. That is excellent.
Jeez.
Oh my God. Folks, I'm doing a charity stream. I'm playing Celeste on 6-5 for 8 hours to see how many levels I can beat. You can donate that day, or you can follow that link and do a pledge, and your pledge will get multiplied by how many levels I can beat in Celeste, and your pledge becomes your donation, and it's pretty fun. So tune into that. All right. There you go, folks. Holy shit. Oh, fuck. It's so good. All right, back to this game. Okay, whew, man. What a fun time that is. Are you still there, Artisma? We lost Artisma. He's
yeah,
not. Oh, he's here. Okay, cool. All right, so we're still sniffing out these baddies. There's still one up there. Where did it go?
Oh no, this one isn't an enemy. This one's a hidden item.
Oh, okay. You obtained a stick. Stick, stupid! Okay. Let's sniff him out. This is such a fun mechanic. I can see why you like this game. I bet, like, all the characters have really diverse, like, ways to play the game and stuff. Oh, there's one. All right, it's that time for me. GF came home starving to death, so I gotta go get food. Thank you for streaming. This makes me want to play again. No problem. And Zero, thank you for popping in, buddy. It is really fucking good to see you there. I'm gonna give you a Slash shout out once again, because you're a solid dude. And then I think I have to add him. Wow, this is hard. Mods, if I've ever told you don't know how to do it, I'm sorry. Unrecognized command shout out. Ugh. shout out? Shout out commands are rough. They are. Zero sacrifice. Let's see if that worked. Hey, everybody go give Zero Sacrifice a follow. He's a solid dude. And you know what? If it were not for Zero Sacrifice, actually, I would not be playing this with Autismo right now, because that's how Autismo found me back in ye old day. I think it was a raid from Zero. So, Zero is a solid dude.
Man, have they really been a year since then?
A year? Oh man, I believe so.
Rough, just the way your mother likes it.
True, didn't think about that. Yeah, so really, it's fortuitous that you showed up tonight, man. Coming full circle. Solid dude. But enjoy your time with your GF, and I'll catch you later, buddy. Hey, there it is. Bye, have a good night. I'm gonna do an exclamation point bye for you. Oh wait, no, that doesn't work. It's not that. I think it's come back. Yeah, there it is.
Come back anytime.
Oh yeah. All right, let's fight this fucking deer. Let's slap its ass. Let's see. We're gonna literally kick this deer's ass. Boom. Shit's over. Ass kicked. You know what? If it was a donkey, that would be even better, because we would literally have kicked ass just now. Oh, nice. We got a haunch of meat. Boo, boo, boo. Now I think we can go back to the elder.
Yeah, you can.
Okay. Oh, wait, but there's one more fart cloud. You obtained a pelt. Man, Ponsa, that fucking, the G slow is so good. All right, I think that means we've killed enough. Like, we don't have to kill all of them. We just have to get enough meat. But
you could kill the rest.
I kind of want to kill the rest. I just like exploring in RPGs, so. And I like the skeletal area. It's kind of fun. Hello. Where'd you go?
Maybe you're gonna find this item at like the front of the skull. Right there.
A hard rock. And then there's one more down here. I have to kill this one. If I don't kill this one, it's like, why bother being a completionist at all? Man, after my deep clean over the weekend, I collected like 69 metric tons of e-waste. I took it to the agency today to give to IT. Agent G is just like, you've already given us so much, we don't have any room. Oh man. Hey, we get to kick ass again. Nice. I will say that this is a very polished game. It is super fun to play like a retro 2D, 3D game like this one. Kick names and take ash. That's right. Okay, Elder, what do you got? Huh? I guess we follow him. I might have to end soon, folks, so feel free to redeem. Oh, you know what? Actually, Autismo, I will ask you. So don't redeem Guide the Raid, but Autismo, if there's anyone on that you like to watch that you want us to raid, let us know. And we will raid that person. Cannot talk to this dude.
Unfortunately, I don't think anyone else on.
Anyone you don't want to raid anybody? Okay. So should I default to the chat then?
Yeah.
Okay. Alrighty. Well then chat, you can now guide the raid if you like. So first one to redeem, we shall head that way. But you gotta redeem the reward. That's how we roll. Probably, I'm not sure when I'll end. Nux? Oh dude, you gotta
Gotta redeem, man. Mr. G slow. Yeah, I know. I got it. Did we not get enough? Nux! Oh, we're gonna get this cloud. Oh, fuck, Jesus. I don't want to talk to you. Yeah, I know. Alright, so we have to fight this cloud.
You could always head to the orange marker on the mini-map if you want to know where to go next.
Hold on. There's a cloud here, though. Oh, but that is his scent. Okay. The orange marker. Okay. That works. Alright, we will raid McNux. After... in a little bit. I sense that the stream will end soon. I'm waiting for a text from Not a Wife to say, please come pick me up from work. So I'm gonna wait that out a little bit. Oh, it's bedtime, baby. But this has been a lot of fun. Oh, where's our buddy? He's gone. Our little Donkey Kong unibrow friend has disappeared. Our unibrow mohawk Donkey Kong friend. Oh, his scent is this way. All right, the scent of our unibrow mohawk Donkey Kong friend. Oh, there's different music at nighttime. I'm just gonna go directly to the objective. Hey, wake up! He just like punches him awake. Ooh. Alright, so we got him. Ooh, what's this? A flower? Don't take it. Weird, I thought punches were for sleeps. How come I'm smelling a flower? That's interesting. Oh, somebody's stealing the meat. Oh, it's probably the lady that we're smelling. Let's go back in there. It kind of gives you a hint that you have to stay there and look a little bit more. You obtained a bone. Hey. It's a girl. Hey, where'd she go? Oh, this is fun. Oh, I know how to do this. Got you. I'm so glad I played the storyline. Select item. What? Dried skins? Does she not have clothes? Is that what she's want? Here. Okay, she doesn't want that. How about... Strong axe? Nope. Oh, jeez.
Try offering her that meat right there.
Oh, that's a good idea. But wait, let me get hit with that thing one more time, and then I'll do that. Let's see. Okay. All right. Haunch of meat. Yep. That also did not work. Son of a bitch.
Hey, A girl needs to eat in privacy, okay?
Oh, I see. So we gotta leave and then come back. That was a good hint. Now what? Now that you've eaten in privacy, can you come out of that thing? It'd be sweet if the rest of the game she was just in that thing. She must be beautiful. She's sparkling. So does she join our party? Wow. Man, I can't believe this wasn't released in the States. This is like so fucking good, man. Although I don't know what the old school one looked like in comparison to this.
You could also argue there was a weird case in the 90s where, I guess for some reason, people thought that Westerns couldn't handle Japanese culture.
Oh, yeah. That makes a lot of sense.
And since two of the chapters are devoted to that particular scene, I can imagine they wouldn't sell well.
Right. That makes sense.
Which is kind of funny, because I assume Westerns would have also loved modern day and far future and such.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I feel like it probably would have done really well. If anything, the, like, cult following it's gained since then is really, like, you know, proven that it is pretty badass. A pretty badass game. A unique one, for sure. But it's also, like, really different than Octopath Traveler. Like, this is way more wacky. And, like, has definite, like, the time period thing is very, like, it's a really cool take on it. Hey, buddy. He's, like, pushing him out of the way. Man, does anybody else have this serious medical condition that this guy has where, like, a giant balloon comes out of your mouth when you sleep? PwnStock says, kind of like how Earthbound wasn't really a hit, but grew a cult following, and it's also amazing. Yeah.
Yeah, Earthbound had a weird advertisement stick where, I guess, because it was the 90s, in order to sell the game, Nintendo sold it as though it was, like, a really disgusting and gross game to play, and that was supposed to be the incentive for you to buy Earthbound.
I see.
Like, to the point where, I think, like, some of the official guidebooks for Earthbound had scratchable, like, those weird scratchable pictures you get in books where if you scratch it, you can smell the scent of it.
Oh, wow.
But it was based off some of the enemies in the game, so it smelled pretty bad. Yeah.
Wow. The nerd did a segment about it. The angry nerd? Yeah. So I feel like I'm doing this section wrong.
You have to go back to where you found her and bring the haystack.
Oh, got it. Okay. Let me just check my text messages real quick. Is this your favorite RPG, Autismo?
I would say it's certainly one of my favorites. I just think that there's a lot of things I love about it. If I had the time, I could just talk endlessly about.
Cool. That's great. All right, so we have to get ones for everybody, I think. Or no, just her, maybe?
No, just her.
Just her. Oh, okay, gotcha.
Familiar with you guys.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so it's you know, they get... Wait a second. Let's talk about how on the loading screen, she is, like, still in the haste. Oh, my God. It's, like, that attention to detail that makes this game truly a delight. That is so good. I'm sorry. I just think that's great. All right, cool. Hey, bud.
Move.
He's the angriest nerd you've ever heard. He is, Ponesaw. He is. Cool. Cool. Are we going to sleep now? What the? Man, it's
well,
really.
At least we're gonna attempt to sleep.
I like that the flag is there to show you, like, what to do. Oh, he's like, she gets the bed, or she gets both beds. Aw, oh, they worship her, so she has to sleep in... She gets to sleep in one of the beds. Oh, okay. I see what you're trying to do there, buddy. Hmm. Maybe this is the reason it couldn't get to the U.S., if you know what I mean. Daytime. let's see. Whoop. Sorry, just give me one sec. All right, had to respond to a text message. We shall play more. There is a small chance that we will have a significant amount of time more, and I can switch to a new storyline. We shall see, though. I can't leave.
You're looking for the girl.
I see. Let's see. Maybe she's in here? Oh, I know. She's in here. Pretty silly. So I guess she's still undercover. One sec.
You know what you need to do.
Sorry, one second. All right, I think we will actually end stream now, but we'll come back to this. Thank you so much. Perfect Fitness is here. What's up, Perfect Fitness? Thank you so much, Autismo, for this lovely game. It was a lot of fun to play. And if I quit out of here, I'm assuming it will say... Oh, I have to probably save it myself.
Yeah.
I'll do a second slot to save it. Cool. All right. So you don't have anybody... Last chance. Nobody's on your list to raid.
Nah, no one I know is streaming right now.
Okay. Then let's check in and see if Nux is still on. And we will... raid him. But thank you so much, man. This was a lot of fun. Alright, let's see. McNux is still on. So we're gonna go hang with McNux, who is a solid dude, super supportive, super friendly, just awesome. An excellent choice, Bonesaw, for Guide the Raid. Have a great night, everybody. Oh, next week, I will not be able to stream at all. So I hope you enjoyed the DJ stream last night and the gaming stream tonight. I will be back the following week, though, with a gaming stream. Maybe a third DJ stream this month? I don't know. Probably not, though. I don't think I'll have time for it. But definitely a gaming stream. One last gaming stream before the month is over, and then we get into June. And the first week of June is lit, because we're doing the Celeste Megasode, which is... I'll be playing Celeste for... Oh, that's the wrong one! Oh, fuck! That's the old Megasode. There we go. I'm going to be playing... So ignore the Resident Evil 4 thing, because that's a while ago. But I'll be playing Celeste for 8 hours for Rainbow Railroad to kick off Pride Month. And you can donate that day, or you can donate the day after when I'll be streaming, because 6-6 is my 3-year streamiversary on Twitch, and I'll be doing a long gaming stream and a long DJ stream on that day. So donations are open the 5th and the 6th. Or you can follow that link to pledge an amount to donate later, and you can watch the Celeste Megasode, and however many levels of Celeste I beat that day, you're committing to donating your pledge multiplied by that number. So yeah, should be a lot of fun. Have a great night, everybody, and enjoy McNux. Oh, and also Autismo. Have a solid week, and we'll see you around in the chat and stuff like that. Thanks for being an awesome, supportive dude and for picking such a dope-ass game. All right. Everybody, get ready to raid McNux.
Thanks, man.
Of course, dude. Take care. Peace out.